the latest inductee into the Catholic League Hall of Fame, Carl Fornoff. Congratulations, brother. Well done. Good seeing you again, buddy.
Wow, what an introduction that was. I don't think you're going to meet anybody who knows Washington College basketball history like he just did. I didn't think I remembered some of those names. I was really, really lucky. A lot of people here have said they're really lucky. And I really was. I had a coach at Gardenville Rec Center when I was 9 years old, and my brothers did too, Mr. Bill Grace, who taught us so much about basketball. All right. He was inspiring. He did way more than teach us basketball, and so that we could be inspired by all these other coaches. I had Coach Popra, and we were, I went to public school through ninth grade, so I came there in the 10th grade, and it was obvious we were undersized right away. We didn't have anybody over 6'3". And my father, I grew up hearing stories about Red Shield Boys Club and mental toughness. We had speeches every week in my household about mental toughness, and Gary Williams in the house, that's all I could say when I think of mental toughness. When I got to Curley, I'm like, wow, we're pretty undersized, Dad. He's like, look, you know, you don't get rebounds by being tall. You get rebounds by getting to the ball first. And I, like any teenage kid, I dismissed my dad kind of quietly, respectfully, but quietly. Like, he really doesn't know today's game. And a couple years later, I was in a basketball camp, and George Rowling, I got to be in a rebound class with George Rowling, who was one of the authorities at the time in rebounding. He asked for volunteers, and I volunteered, so I'm there with, of course, it's me and, you know, 6'6", 6'7", 6'5", 6'8". And the whole camp comes over to see the drill he was about to do, because he had this reputation. And the first thing out of his mouth, you could guess, and he said it very loudly, and he spit. I could feel his spit on me when he said it. He said, listen, I want you to know, you don't get rebounds by being tall. You get rebounds by getting to the ball first. So, you know, there you go, Dad. I didn't, you know, I guess at that time I might have said, my dad was right one time. But Coach Popper, we had, I must have been a match for Coach Popper, because when I came there, he had these intense practices, quick. You know, it was never boring. He had four or five ways to teach one fundamental. We moved between things so quickly. He would, a lot of times, we'd go out to practice, and he'd be jogging onto the court right with us. We weren't supposed to walk, even to get a drink. So we're running back and forth. And it was just, I mean, it was hard work, but it was really, really fun. I'll never forget that. And I carry that, you know, in my work life. I work in disadvantaged communities. I work for Catholic Charities, and a lot of times we're up against a lot of adversity, and that really helps me, that you can have fun, you can work really hard, but there's always, as you heard tonight, so many funny stories, comedy and humor and lightness to go with it. So I just feel very appreciative of that. I also heard a lot of stories about high school coaches having to wear so many hats. Well, Coach Popra was another one. He was a driver, a coach, a trainer. Oh yeah, I injured my ankle for the first time, and there's no way I was gonna not practice or whatever, and I didn't know what taping an ankle was or anything like that. I just, he had me on the, propped up on the bleachers while practice was starting to begin, and he was taping my ankle. Well, he just is like strangling the ankle. I mean, he's just wrapping it up so that it's numb and it won't hurt. You know? And he gets done. And I'm looking at the other guys. I can't wait to get out there. It was a long day at school. And I get done. And he says, well, you know, tell me how does that feel? And I go, Coach, it's on the wrong foot. He's ready to start practice. He gets the JV coach to tape the correct angle. And this guy, Coach Ed Jones, he's just as tough. He's bragging that thing all around. So I had to go for the first time, you know, later on in college, I was like, you get your ankles taped every night. But that day, I'm walking around with two numb feet in practice. So a lot of these things happen, and I never will forget, and I appreciate that so much. But really why I'm here is because I had Hall of Fame parents and a Hall of Fame family, and the coaches I had are just out of this world. And the competition in the Catholic League made me so much better than I was ever going to be. I mean, I never thought that our team could do some of the things that we did. And people would say we upset. I so appreciate that you didn't use the word upset teams, because we didn't think we upset them. We actually believed that we were better than teams when we played them. And the last thing I wanted to tell you, and I never forget this, I think I have the number of points different, but we played against Tony Guy, Quentin Daly. I guarded Quentin Daly. He was, you know, in my class, so every game, I was the one that was guarding Quentin Daly, and you could tell by my non-verbals that that was not an easy thing. Mm-hmm. Well, we actually lost. In my junior year, we lost to Gibbons by 42 points. And Quentin Daly, that's when I learned what a tomahawk dunk was. My neck was sore from moving like that. And I think I cried on the way home with my dad next to me in the car. And 9 days later, this is how tough a team we were. 9 days later, we beat the very same team, same lineup, same guys, Quentin Daly, the whole thing, and we beat them. And I just will never, ever forget that, because we became greater than, you know, the sum of our parts. So thank you very much, and thanks to the Hall of Fame parents and Hall of Fame coaches. Thank you.